We have tried to look at what the problems that face the country are to try to find solution if we can.
I don't see any good thing about this constitutional draft at all. A way for the military regime and the traditional elite to try to establish a legitimacy so that they can interfere in Thai politics.
What this constitution attempts to do is to find way out. When there is deadlock, how do you find compromise?
The people who benefit most from this draft constitution is the traditional elite and the military regime, as they are trying to control the electoral system. The elected government, if this constitution passes, will be a weak government. We are under the oppressive atmosphere. People who are trying to campaign are banned. Students are arrested. It's okay for the people who say they are going to accept the draft constitution, but people who are going to reject the constitution, they don't have space, don't have freedom to do it.
You're seeing people campaigning every day in social media, politicians coming out. Nothing wrong with that. Don't intimidate people. Don't use money or cash to influence people. People are arrested because of what they have committed.
If the constitution is approved by a majority who come out to vote, it means that the military regime will have political legitimacy. So the vote no to the draft constitution on this Sunday, it means that it's a way for the people, majority of people in this country, to show to the military regime that we don't want them in politics.
I'm speaking as a Thai that has seen the chaos of the past. Thais want democracy, but if you were to ask them that, with that democracy, do you want that same chaos and violence in the streets? That was 2 years ago. People forget all this.